Welcome to the online session of Power Plant Engineering. My name is Vishal Acharya. Today we will discuss about the types of the cooling tower and types of the cooling pond. First, in a power station like a steam power plant, where large amount of exhaust steam is generated by the steam turbine and passed to the condenser, where the hot water is converted into the cold water. Now, the cold water that is used in a condenser to the convert to the hot water to the cold water is supplied by the cooling tower. The main purpose of the cooling tower is to separate the heat from the hot water and make it cool and recirculate the water in a condenser. The cooling tower use or requirement where the large amount of cooling effect is required, like a power plant and some industrial area. The main principle of the cooling tower is same the evaporation. Here, hot water air is directly contact with each other, and here air is extracted the heat or latent heat of water. So here water make to the cool, and here temperature of the air is increased. So air is evaporate of some water particle also. This is the basic principle of the cooling tower. Here in a industry or power plant, hot water is sprayed to the field by the help of the nozzle. Here nozzle is directly attached with the hot water pipe, and the fin design hexagonal cavity so that here said water or steam is droplet small and slowly. Here air is coming from the bottom of the cooling tower and it move upward direction, is contact with the field. Here the air and the water is directly contact. So air is extract the heat from the water and make the water is the cool, but temperature of the air is increased and some water particle is evaporated by the hot air. Here the evaporating action occurring to the field area, and the evaporating water further cooled down at low temperature. This is the evaporation method in a cooling tower, and the surface where occur the evaporation is called the evaporating surface. Here hot water is convert into the cool water, but the hot air and evaporate water is escaped from the cooling tower. But here we have arranged the drift elimator. Here drift elimator is used for the here water is cooled down and convert into the cold water. So here evaporator water is converted into the cold water, and drift elimator is allow to the accept the air from the cooling tower, and it try to prevent the water to escape from the cooling tower. So here drift elimator main use to minimize the loss of the water in a cooling tower is the main function of the drift elimator, and the cold water droplet is downward side and is getting into the basin, and the cold water is supplied to the condenser by the help of the centrifugal pump. This is the basic principle of the all the cooling tower. Here types of the cooling tower. First is the natural draft cooling tower. and second is the forced draft and induced draft cooling tower. Here forced draft and induced draft cooling tower is the type of mechanical draft cooling tower. First is the natural draft cooling tower. Natural draft cooling tower is a simple type of cooling tower where the air supply is naturally in a cooling tower without use any mechanical device like fan or blower. Here all device like a drip telemeter for preventing the water outside, fins or heat exchanger for transfer the heat, the principle of the natural draft cooling tower is same as we discussed above. Here this type of the cooling tower is used in a power plant like a steam power plant and a nuclear power plant. Our second type of the cooling tower is the mechanical draft tower. In a mechanical draft cooling tower we require the mechanical component like fan or blower for the circulation of the air inside the cooling tower, so that here the efficiency of the forced draft and induced draft cooling tower is high compared to the natural draft cooling tower. First here forced draft cooling tower. In a forced draft cooling tower the position of air in blower is bottom of the cooling tower. Here force air is supplied inside the cooling tower and airflow is moved upward . This is the basic principle of the forced draft cooling tower, and remaining all the parts are same as the natural draft cooling tower. Next is the induced draft cooling tower. In an induced draft cooling tower, here we use the blower at the position is above the cooling tower. Here we suck the air from the bottom open hole. Here air is sucked and airflow is upward this direction, and any other device is same as the natural draft cooling tower. Next is the cooling pond. Cooling pond is used when the requirement of the cooling action is not big volume or small volume used. First is the natural flow of cooling pond. Second is the director flow of cooling pond. Third is the single deck spray pond. Fourth is the double deck spray pond. And last is the spray pond with the fins. First is the natural flow of the cooling pond. Here hot water is coming from the condenser and is allowed to the flow in a open side or pond. Here the heat transfer action is occurred with the help of the convection phenomena. This is the simple method of the cooling process, but nowadays this type of the cooling pond is not used. Our second pond is the directed flow cooling pond. Here water is coming from the condenser in a center line of the pond, and here we use the baffle for the two pass current. Here the convection effect is more than the natural flow or natural flow cooling pond, so your efficiency is high compared to the first one. Next is the single deck spray pond. Here the hot water is coming from the condenser and spray over a large area of the pond. So here the hot water is converted into the cold water by the action of the evaporation process. Next is the double leg spray. Here the arrangement of the nozzle not in a single level but the different level. And last is the spray pond with the fins. Here we require the fins for the heat loss prevent. Here when the velocity of the wind is very high, some water loss here, so we require the loss of the water and heat transfer loss. We arrange the fins for the improving the heat transfer effectiveness and the loss, minimize the loss of the water. Thank you.